Hi everyone, so I actually had to restart, and the reason for that is because I wasn't doing too hot in this dungeon, but the only thing that I did differently is that I went up to this room, and I'll show you where that is in a second, and I got a stray fairy over here and a treasure chest which contained the map, so that was pretty helpful. And this is located right in that first area with the freezards, so it's not difficult to access. I just went an alternate route, and I had saved at the owl statue initially, but as I said before, I wasn't doing that great in this dungeon, so things didn't go how I wanted it to, and I decided to restart and do it better. So here I am again. Alright, hi everyone, I'm finally back to where I was, and I realized that there was a stray fairy in here that I didn't get, so I'm gonna go ahead and do that right now. I decided to be a little inconsistent, and I'm going to start uploading these videos, not in episodes, because I've obviously been doing that, but I'm going to start introducing them, so it'll definitely feel more episodic instead of just cutting off abruptly. And as I said in the previous episode, I'm going to do that to make it more enticing and engaging for newcomers, so they're not going to feel lost, and it'll get them right into the groove, so I think that'll be good. Anyway, the purpose of this puzzle, I was a little stuck in it last time, but we're going to activate these switches, maneuver the pillars, and get it so that we can have access to that door over there. And what that does right here is it lowers it, so now I'm going to hopefully get up here in time with that green switch. Yay! Alright, just in the nick of time. So that was good. Obviously that block of ice was preventing us from going in that direction, so we had to take advantage while we could. Alright, so now I'm across, and this is obviously blocking, so I'm going to... This is a sort of testing of your skills. We're going to have to ramp across and see. I fell into the pit. That is conveniently... No, punch it. I just want these rupees. Okay, not that I need rupees anyway, because again, I'm at my maximum amount. Yeah, it's just a testing of your skills because there is a convenient little catcher right there. And this is actually not... I mean, it is the Goron dungeon, but it's not the test of your skills. That is reserved for towards the end of the game, and it's some of the most difficult platforming that I've ever experienced in a Zelda title. Nothing we can do in this room quite yet. Actually, yes, there is, and I'll show you right now. So I'm a little more familiar with this dungeon just because I was just about completed. I didn't finish the boss or anything, but I was just seeing how far I could get, because I tried recording. But this is a tricky bit of platforming right here. This is absurd. I'm doing better than I was last time, so that's good. It's not fun falling in this dungeon, because you're going to have to traverse your way back up. And not that it's too much of a pain at all, it's just when I'm recording, it's not going to be the most riveting entertainment to watch that. Alright, anyway, all of these snowballs are going to have some special items in there, so we can replenish our magic, and that's very helpful. But now we made it across here. And there is a patch of ice, so I believe I stated this earlier, but the rest of it is thawed out. So only on this patch of ice are you going to be able to build up your speed and get it so that the spikes will initiate and you can cross that ramp. So this is what the dungeon is composed of. It's just going to be ramping across until we can have access to the pillar that we're going to shoot skyrocket in the center. And this is Wizrobe. It's a pretty ugly mini-boss. And we're going to have to fight him twice for some reason. I mean, I'd rather they not just reuse the same enemy, at least in the same dungeon. So I don't think that is particularly creative, but it's not that big of a deal. I mean, he does get more difficult, but again, I wish that was reserved for a later part of the game, because that's usually how they do it. But Wizrobe is not too difficult at all. I recommend using Goron Link. and you're going to have to wait. So if you... Oh, that's not a good way to do it. So if you get too close to him before he starts dancing, then he's going to disappear, and I'll showcase what that means. Actually, never mind, I can't. Never mind. I beat him. I'll probably showcase it on the next one, because it is more difficult. But he makes copies of himself, so holograms, and he runs across the room. I mean, it's not too much of a hassle at all. You can use arrows. That's another recommended method, but, I mean, it's easier to just roll right up to him. You got the fire arrow! Set it to C to power up your arrows. Things will heat up when they hit. Not only heat up, I mean, they're scorching hot. It's pure fire. So, I mentioned this previously, but all of the items that you'll find in dungeons in Majora's Mask are going to be upgrades of your arrow, and that's it. And not that there's anything wrong with that. I actually quite like that aspect. It works with the game. I think tapping on the buttons and wiggling the control stick allows you to thaw faster, but I could be wrong. That's usually how it is in most games. But anyway, it just works with the dungeon design, and Majora's Mask more than makes up for it in the items that you can get outside of the dungeon. That is a fact that I believe to be very true, because all these masks with their unique abilities is just really impressive to see, and I think it's amazing how diverse they are. So the dungeons don't have to necessarily have unique items. Alright, from here, it got a little wonky. It was weird trying to access one of these ledges. So there it is. I didn't actually successfully pull that off. We're gonna have to jump across, and I think I'm gonna use the bunny hood. But there's nothing we can do on this level yet. We're going to have to raise the center column. So I'm just gonna attempt to get this, and I hope that I can pull it off. It is a difficult jump. I think I can do it, though, especially with the bunny hood. So, jump, Link, jump! You can do it! Oh, no! Oh, no! Yeah, so we're gonna have to try that again after. It is quite hard to get to that area, but that's okay, because we have to go back down here anyway. Since we have fire arrows, there's new areas that we can access. Don't hit me, skulls. Flaming skulls, that's not okay. That hurts me. It feels very depressing when you decide to just attack me like that. You gang up on me. All right, anyway, now that we have the fire arrows, we can access this area. And I like how, when I attempted that jump, I mean, Link couldn't fit through the bars, and the reason for that is because, well, I mean, I guess he's not supposed to, but it seems like he could slide them through, or at least grab them if this was real life. But the bars just act as wall textures, so there's nothing you can really do about that. Anyway, we have to defeat all these freezards. I've been saying anyway as a transition a lot, I apologize. But Majora's Mask is weird in that only sometimes will you have to defeat every enemy on screen. You won't always get a reward. I mean, it's just something you might want to try out if you're stuck. That's always a Zelda go-to. I know it's nothing new, but I mean, I just find it strange that Majora's Mask decides when and where. I think A Link to the Past was a little bit better about that all throughout the game, because usually in every dungeon, there was some room where you had to defeat the enemies. It was made obvious because the door would lock, but this one is just fairly normal. I mean, if you want to get all of the great fairy, or the stray fairies, you're going to have to experiment in each room. And that's what I recommend most. That is my number one tip. You just have to see what happens. So, we raised the column, as I said we would do, and there is no reason to ever disactivate this. So, once you hit the switch, you don't have to lower it again. And sort of also what I meant about the bars is that it's not a graphical glitch, but it's kind of weird how it just stays midair. I mean, it definitely does act as a wall. There's no sliding through that. You might be able to shoot arrows through it, and I'm just curious, so I'm gonna do it now. Nope, you can't shoot arrows through it, so it sticks. That is quite odd. Just sticks to the wall. So it acts as a solid property. And I don't know how it is in the 3DS version. It must be the same, but I find that strange because that'd look a little odd with the updated graphics. I mean, you kind of expect some of these things from the N64, but I don't know. I mean, I guess it'd be... That's just nice aesthetically. Sorry, I'm getting sidetracked, but it's cool to see the bars there, and I prefer them being there. I just don't want... I don't know, it's just kind of strange that it would act as a wall. I guess I understand because they don't want players accessing things they couldn't before. For example, if you're in that closed off area, they don't want you hitting any switches that might be outside. Not that there is any in this dungeon, but that's just an example of how that could be abused. So, I mean, they could accommodate for shooting through bars, but I don't think they did in this situation. And I'd rather it not be a solid wall. So now we have the fire arrows. We haven't been through here again yet. So we can actually hit everything that we hadn't previously. I thought he was frozen again. I made that mistake the last time. But he's not, and we're not even gonna bother. One thing that I noticed that I didn't last time is that if you try to attack these things with your sword, you're going to have a bad time because it takes about 8 hits with Link's sword in this state. I mean, it's the lowest, it's not upgraded yet. But still, 8 hits, and it only takes 2 to defeat them with Goron Link's punch. That's a little absurd if you ask me. I mean, he's proving to be quite annoying, so I'm probably gonna take care of him, but definitely, definitely be Goron Link or use some sort of item. Because there is just no way that you're gonna... I mean, it takes forever. He blocks all of Link's hits. It's a little ridiculous. Like, how is he immune to slashes from a sword? That is a blade. And imagine, like, all that it's been through. I mean, I guess it's a bit used up, but still. There's no excuse for that. Anyway, this acts a bit slower because we're not pushing a block through snow this time. It's through ice, so it's going to slide faster, as you just saw. And it's a puzzle in that you have to angle it properly. I mean, there's plenty of places where you can put it, but I think that's it for this room. I'm just going to check really quick, and it's another tip that I recommend. You check with the Great Fairy's Mask before you exit a room. And that way, you'll know that even if it's inaccessible, if you know there's a stray fairy in there, you can either go back, or you know that a room is absolutely 100% complete, and you don't have to worry about it anymore. And that's the best thing to me. So I think we're all good. Now we can melt this. This whole dungeon, I really like its layout because once you get... I mean, this is like every other dungeon in the game, but they accommodate. They consider you falling off. I mean, what I did when I purposefully jumped at the top, if you accidentally fall off, it can be discouraging, but there are ways to get back up faster, and this is all about shortcuts and enabling you to go to areas that you weren't previously able to have access to. Alright, now we're gonna have to navigate our way through. We can't ramp. The ramp is currently being encompassed by that giant pillar, so we're gonna have to make our way around. So let's do that right now. And I think we're gonna have to go all the way across. It's not a big deal. It's just something to consider, because you have to navigate around it. You can't just conveniently ramp off like I was able to before. That's the only thing. I mean, everything is ease of access in this dungeon, and it's pretty great. I don't know why. I mean, I guess as a kid, everything's a little more confusing, but I just sort of got lost in the mix. I mean, I didn't... Yeah. I've talked about it a little bit, but I just had a different thought process than I do now. Not as effective, so... Okay, now we're in here. Oh, actually, I definitely know where to go. Not downstairs. I don't want to go downstairs, Goron Link. Because like I said, you do not have to activate that again. I mean, actually, we could go downstairs. There's two ways to get back up. I guess I'll showcase them now. So I'm gonna go in that room that I started this episode with. Do a somersault, Link, that's good. I think this is, or a cartwheel off the off the ledge. Yeah, there's two ways to access it. You can go all the way downstairs, like I was about to, and there are golden Deku flowers that'll help you get back up, and we'll see. I'll probably use that. I'll go that route because I'm gonna have to jump off again to get that great fairy, or stray fairy. I keep making that mistake. I'm gonna have to jump off to get the stray fairy that I missed last time. And one thing I'd like to add here, I don't know if you can see it. Come on, Tattle. Well, Tattle will go down and highlight a specific area, and that is that ledge right over here. And if you... Yep, there she is. If you have the hookshot, which is given to you in the next area of the game, and you're trying to go back, probably to get all the stray fairies that you missed. But if you get the hookshot and you come back here, it's going to be even easier to progress because you can summon the Scarecrow character, if you remember from the earlier episodes, pretty early on in the game, the one that allowed you to dance. So if you summon him, you have to talk to him, and I'll definitely show you, because I'm going to have to if I'm doing this 100%. You need him for heart pieces. But you talk to him, you show him your ocarina, and he teaches you a song that allows you to let him rise in three key areas. And I think there's only three areas. Two of them are for heart pieces, and the only other one is in this dungeon, and it allows you to just hookshot and go up there seamlessly. So that's the only benefit. I mean, it's not really needed, especially if you're not doing it 100%. It's only two heart pieces, so it's not like you're missing out on a whole container or something, or like a unique specialty item. So you don't, casual players don't worry about that. You don't need to get the Scarecrow, because it is a little confusing. It's the most obscure thing in Majora's Mask, I think, because he doesn't tell you how it works. He just teaches you the song, and you're like, okay, I don't know what this does. And you just kind of have to know that you summon him in the areas that Tattle highlights. It's kind of weird. All right, this is the second Wizrobe battle. And actually, we're pretty much done this dungeon already. So that's very quick. It's not a long dungeon at all if you know where you're going. So where is he? Okay, this is a little more difficult because he gets up there. I can't quite reach him. I can't punch him up there. Yeah, it's a little more difficult just because there is that one ledge and there's more areas that he can rise. So, yeah. I mean, here's the phase two where he activates his holograms. And he's running around erratically. It's very scary. Alright, come on, Wizrobe. Let's go. Where are you? Oh. Yeah, if you miss, just forget about it. Just dodge the attack. There's no getting around that. And if you walk in his little ice, wherever he used the spell, you will freeze. So he doesn't have to hit you directly. I think he's on top of the ledge. Nope, nope, he's in the center. So it's a bit tricky seeing exactly where the real one is, but he's more solid and he will be the only one that's dancing. So you have to look around. I mean, that's when an arrow would come in handy, because you can just shoot from wherever you are. You have access to a little bit more range, so I'm actually going to take a little break. I'm just going to pause it and get some water. Alright, I'm back. Yeah, I know how comedians drink water on stage, or they have a glass of water, because man, your throat gets dry talking for that long. Because I had spoken for about 40 minutes prior to this in an unreleased episode. My first attempt at this dungeon that, again, didn't go too well. Now we have the boss key, and we can actually complete this temple at any time. We're free to go up there. And there's no repercussions to doing so. I just can't get everything I need for the stray fairy. But I'm not gonna work like that. Why did I just go back in there? That's not what I want to do. No. Alright, so I have the boss key. Now I can go around. I'm probably gonna go to the center column again. Let's just see I can't quite remember where that ledge was that I have to jump. Let's see where that is first and foremost. Because I'm probably going to have to do that again. Because I want to go back and get all of the stray fairies. I believe it's down there somewhere. Also, something peculiar is that I don't quite know where those locked door, where the keys are. Which is kind of odd, because I've meticulously gone through this dungeon. And I'm not gonna look up a walkthrough for this, so... Alright, where are you? There it is. Do I dare jump that again? Do I really want to? Well, let's just see first. That's the staircase. Perhaps I can go this way. No, that's just down the stairs. I guess I'll try it again. I mean, the only other way... Oh, we have to get the Deku Flower. Alright, I know what I'm doing. Trust me, I know what I'm doing. But I'm gonna jump. I'm gonna try to jump this. Might as well do it. Alright, I keep losing it. Okay, so... Attempt number two. How about directly on? I don't want to use the Goron roll because I can bounce off the wall. The bunny hood is an absolute necessity. Let's try this again. Come on, Link, you can do it. You can do it, Link. You can do it. Yes! Alright, we got it. So you just have to get a big running start. Bunny hood, entirely recommended. I don't know how you do it any other way. But now we have the 11th Stray Fairy. So there's four more in this dungeon we're going to have to find, and I believe I know where they are. Let's just go this way. Yeah, let's go in here. Okay. This is one place that I haven't been yet. So, fairy, no shimmering. We're going to have to melt this block. This ice block. And that gives us access to the golden flower. So now we can conveniently make our way up. And this isn't required. You don't have to do this. It's just a little secret thing that I found pretty cool. I mean, this golden flower isn't used a lot in the game at all. But when it is, it's really awesome to see. I think the only other places that it's used is in the final temple and the spider house, which I haven't done yet. It's in the swamp, but I'm going to wait until I have the hookshot, because that makes it a heck of a lot easier. If I'm going to do that, I think this is the wrong way. And again, 3D, Majora's Mask 3 can fix some of those errors, so they had a little more time to perfect. And I think it's perfect as it is, honestly. I mean, this game is an absolute masterpiece, and any other elements completely outweigh the little errors, and I find it kind of charming. So, last time we went over there, and that was the boss key. Now we're going to go to the right, and this is going to give us access to some other rooms that we haven't been yet. And this, I think that's the only way to do it. Because you can't ramp off that ledge at all. And I think this area is... Yeah, this area is completely optional. There's no need to go here unless you want the stray fairies. But, I don't know, it's just kind of cool. So these are a pushover with the Goron. There's no need to, I think they only take one hit. There's no need to try and fight them with your sword. But here we go, melt this ice. I mean, perhaps there is another alternate way to get in here, but that's just easier to go all the way to the top and use the Deku Flower. I said we wouldn't be using Deku Link again, but there we are, using that flower. There should be a stray fairy in here. And there's these snow monsters. I mean, fire is their natural enemy, so let's just defeat them. Oh, wow, they don't even break into smaller pieces. That's pretty cool. They just melt instantly. Awesome. Here I was trying to fight them with Goron punches, and they'd break into three smaller pieces. And the reason I unequipped the fire arrows is because I have to use... I mean, I don't have to. I guess I know where it is. But if you use a Lens of Truth, you cannot use fire arrows. It won't let you. And, like, it works If you have fire arrows equipped and you're completely out of magic, it will work just like regular arrows, but that's not how it does it here. And of course they respawn. So there's one last stray fairy, and I know where it is. I don't know quite how to get to that room. But that is pretty much, that's how you go about that aspect. Oh, I think I found out what I have to do. Okay, so, I don't know why I didn't think of this before, because I only got the treasure chest and I didn't go up here. Yeah, that is the problem. I was wondering, because there is one room that I didn't access yet. Or one area that I hadn't reached. Okay, here we go, thank goodness. Alright, that's it. That is the final stray fairy. Dang it. Gotta go all the way back now. Duh, don't come alive, don't kill me. Alright, this is it. The final stray fairy. Quick, take them to their fellow fairies of the same color. But now, we don't need to do that yet, because we're actually just gonna defeat the boss. There we go, all the stray fairies. I'm pretty excited, because now we get to fight the most interesting boss in the entirety of the game. And that is, you'll see, Goht. I always thought it was Goht, but... So the very plain and ordinary Goht, even though I said he's the most interesting boss of all time. His character design and model is nothing to get excited for, but the fight itself, man is it riveting. And you will see just what I'm talking about. I'm not being sarcastic at all. I know that my tone and demeanor can come off that way, but it's... No, it's really one of the greatest Zelda fights ever. So, definitely something to get excited for. We're just gonna go up this way, because this is the easiest way to access the top, at least from me. Alright, here we go. We have prepared ourselves. We are all ready. We have the fire arrows. We have conquered this dungeon. Look at us. We're all the way at the top. And let's do this thing. These icicles yield us some reward. Some magic. We are free to access. Yeah, look around confused. Okay, there he is. He's a mechanical beast. May or may not resemble a goat. May or may not be called a goat. So the thing you're gonna do is melt the ice. And that's pretty amusing in itself. In that you have to free him first to fight him. And then we can free him. Because the giant is captured inside of this boss's mask. And he's corrupted by Majora, so... Made even more clear. I keep bringing up the 3DS version, but it's made even more clear. Because... A giant eyeball pops out when you attack them. And it's the same color and style as Majora's himself, so... Yeah, so this is pretty cool. We're just gonna beat him up. What you have to do... He's pretty much stampeding around this arena, so it's this complete circular area, and we're gonna have to follow him, as you can see, with the spiky Goron, and this is a very high energy, just awesome battle. It's really fun. He'll shoot electricity at you, and he'll kick up rocks from behind, so you can't directly follow him. I like to stay kind of close to the center column. And things will fall from the ceiling, and eventually he starts throwing bombs, so there's all sorts of things coming at you. There's all kinds of hazards. Complete electricity. He shoots it out of his butt. I don't know what, who built him and for what purpose, but just keep attacking him. I mean, that's probably the best way to do it. Goron Link's punch is very powerful. And towards the end of the game, you will, if you've collected all the masks, you will get the ultimate mask, and it's really extremely useful in defeating the bosses again, if you so desire. But in this case, it doesn't really help. Oh wow, I already beat him. Okay. He didn't even get a chance to throw bombs. I think I skipped his final form, so he's just gonna run into the wall. But yeah, extremely fun boss battle. Even fun to just replay it time and time again. Usually, I don't do it that fast, so that was pretty... That was pretty awesome. Okay. Now, I don't quite know where he landed. So we're just gonna have to circle this area. I think everything's normal. Also, I love how there's convenient pods placed all around to replenish magic. Oh, there he is. Alright. Let's get this heart container. And Goht's remains. You've seized Goht's remains. You have just freed the innocent spirit that this dark mask had kept imprisoned within the body of evil Goht. Yeah, so they're, the giants are kept prisoner inside of there. Now we're treated with this cutscene again, with the bubbles and ghosting effect. We're in the hot tub. What exactly are all of you? So this is Tattle speaking. There's the second giant. Friends. Guardians. Guardians? So, you're protective gods. That's why you're in the temples. But, why are the protective gods... No, wait! Are you listening to me? Hey! Wait! So clearly we only get a limited amount of time to interact with them. And now, the ice is slowly melting. Yay, it's spring again in the mountains, and now we're free to a lot of additional content, actually. And I'm gonna showcase just quite what that is in a few moments after retreating with this cutscene. That only initiates when you beat Goht for the first time. So anytime you do this after, it's just going to cut to Link exiting the dungeon and everything is thawed out. But that's the second area. I mean, we did it and we're teleported out of the dungeon. And there is one of the frogs. So this starts a side quest. I might as well begin it now because I'm going to be going to Great Bay pretty dang soon. Anyway, well, actually, no, I needed to be there on the first day, that's right. Never mind, but you can interact with these frogs. I'll do that later, though. So anyway, now the post-temple content. Now that it is spring, we have access to a few different... Oh, what's this, actually? Oh yeah, that is the Goron races. But the first thing, before I forget, because I've totally done this before and it's pretty embarrassing. Now look at that fire bellowing out of the chimney. Dang. Okay. Now the smelter works. So we're gonna actually teleport back up to Snowhead, which is still snowing, but it's supposed to. It's just not cursed anymore. Yeah, this is probably the most important thing to remember. Whenever you complete- Oh my gosh, I didn't even know he was there. I totally did not know he was there. Dharmani, what in the world have I been doing this whole time? I can't remember a thing since I went out to look around Snowhead to figure out why spring wasn't coming. What am I doing sitting in a place like this? Interesting. What in the world have I been doing this whole time? Alright, well, that is Big Goron, and I was mistaken before. I assumed that he had fallen and he opens up shop in Goron Village, but that is a different one. It's called Metagoron, which is also pretty big, but he's much larger. So they're different people, and I didn't know that you could interact with him when he's sitting up here. That's really, really cool. Dang, okay. I must have known that, though, because I had to return the stray fairy, so maybe I just forgot. I just like that detail. He climbed back up. He's not dead. We didn't kill him. It's okay. So the fairy's fountain is somewhere. Yep, right there. Yep, we're gonna return all the stray fairies and get our reward. Get them back together, girl. Piece yourself together. Hey. Hello, scary looking woman with pointy breasts. That is terrifying. Green makeup. Oh, wise young one, I am the great fairy of wisdom with blue text. Even though you're green. Thank you for returning my broken and shattered body to normal. As thanks, I shall enhance your magic power. Ah, thank you. Pretty useful reward. The other ones include... preventing you from taking damage from enemies. I think it cuts all damage in half, which is really effective and cool. That face. Your magic power has been enhanced. You now have twice as much magic power. So that's awesome. Come and see me whenever you're overcome by weirdness. I will not come and see you ever again because you were in an inconvenient location. I'm going to go back to Gorn Village, actually, and speak with the Gorn Elder's son. But I think that is actually going to do it. Let me teleport to an owl statue. We beat the dungeon, and that should do it for today. But I will see you all next time. Thank you so much for watching. It means a lot to me. And this is Halloween. It's going to be coming up pretty soon. This is the month of October. And I am preparing for that. I have a Dark Aspects episode planned in addition to the one that I just did covering Tulip, which I highly recommend even if you haven't seen the game or heard about it before. But all my social media pages, every single day I am doing something Halloween themed. But if you ever want to stop your save progress, you're going to save at the owl statue, but there is risks and repercussions if you don't follow what he says, and I'm going to explain what that is next time, so